What does it feel like to be embraced by the Amazon jungle? More importantly, what will happen if I miss this once-in-a-lifetime experience before I leave this country tomorrow? My name is Zachary, and this story starts a year ago when the unexpected happened. I lost connection with my closest friend, a 7-year marriage, in fact, and my broken heart needed a hug. A normal hug wouldn't be enough, though. I needed a heart-healing hug. Can I feel that in this jungle? Is it worth braving the unknown, drenched in darkness, deep in the jungle, all by myself, the night before my flight? If I don't, tomorrow's plane ride will carry me away from the Amazon with a heart still shattered and a dream left unfulfilled. With the countdown ticking, I'm following my heart away from the airport, deeper into the jungle, in search of a hug on the other side of this rusty cable car.
Along the river, in the river, through the river, over the river. Something about the river and the jungle. That's the goal for today.
I've always had a dream to take a motorized canoe up an Amazonian river, but I never expected it to be like this. To start this adventure into the unknown, let's explore a meal from the river.
We are opening a banana leaf.
So
my river fish is barbecuing inside a banana leaf. I kind of hope one of these is in hiding in my interesting meal that I'm about to partake of. And somehow they think I can drink an entire pitcher of it. That is a lot of payoso. Yeah, my day just gets better and better. Look at this plate of food that I was just served. A lot of bones. Boca Chico fish, fish of the river. Yeah, it's definitely got quite the pile of bones going on. Down to the last drop, down to the last bone. I am one wholeheartedly full and happy Hooley, ready for a jungle adventure.
Why again am I going on this jungle adventure into the unknown? It's my last day in Ecuador, and I should be traveling towards the airport. What is my heart trying to find?
And here it begins. I found myself onto an Amazonian boat, refitted Roberto. Hola, Roberto. And I met him and his wife and his daughter. I'm definitely not with a group. This is obviously a boat where they have groups, but I'm just one person. He's just taking me out, and we're doing $5 just to get up the river. I'm gonna hike in the jungle. And I'm so glad I found just such a friendly guy. Doesn't speak any English. We just struck up a conversation in my limited Spanish. You know, sometimes you have to go with a tour guide and go through the agency, and then you have to pay for the bus, and you get all these different things, but just do local buses and strike up conversations in town, and this is what you get.
I've always traveled off the beaten path, but this is my first time in the Southern Hemisphere. I've been solo traveling across Ecuador, and all the while my broken heart has been searching for healing as I share my vulnerable vlogs. I found comfort at a volcanic spa. I found joy in a national park. I found playfulness at the coast. I found adventure on local buses. I found gratitude in the Central Highlands. I found confidence summoning a volcano. And I recently found trust with my heart in fulfilling two dreams, to sleep beneath a thatched roof, and this right here, ride a motorized canoe up into the Amazon jungle.
I don't know if it gets much better than that for a $5 experience. Woo! Wow, I can't believe I'm living this right now. Look at the trees growing around here. Why not get that Titanic feeling here? All right, at the tip of the boat. And leaning out over into that Ecuadorian sunset.
After finding so many wonderful things on this unplanned trip, my heart still hasn't found the right embrace in all those places. I even left the serenity of the perfect hammock beneath a thatched roof surrounded by beautiful birdsong to answer this whisper in my heart, to go deeper into the wild jungle. Will it be worth the risk? It's at the end of the day. I've never been here. And if I can't find my way back, I'll miss my flight tomorrow.
Ah. Wow. I am in complete awe of this experience right here. beyond my wildest expectations of what I'd be finding here in Ecuador.
That's so cool.
Right over there. He says it's a notria. I'm guessing it's a river otter.
There he goes.
I see the sun setting and I consider playing it safe. I fulfilled my dream on this canoe ride. Maybe I should just head back to my thatched roof and be certain to catch my flight tomorrow. Roberto turns the canoe around and we begin our float down the river.
This should be fun.
Like a powerful rudder, my left-brain logic takes over. I'll just return to the States and find a different kind of healing embrace for my heart. But something inside tells me this rush will never be enough. If there's anything I've learned on the journey from brokenhearted to wholehearted, it's that my heart is worth listening to, no matter how loud my head gets. I tell Roberto to pull over and drop me off in the middle.
Found me a random docking station here, not going to one of the tourist places where you pay to go into a different thing and see kind of a tourist attraction. I just stopped right here by this beautiful creek. Perfecto. Muchas gracias, Roberto. Perfecto. All right, una hora. So he just dropped me off here. He says, this is the jungle. You wanted wild jungle? This is wild jungle. He asked me if I had any cell service or anything. I'm like, nope, sure don't. Oh, adventuring into the unknown. That's what I get to work with. Exactly what I wanted. Ah, look at this. So good. Oh, it's just so lush and green. Oh, I see something up there. That's where I'm headed.
I'm just having fun here, but I have no idea what I'm about to feel up ahead.
Ooh, slippery. Still want to go slipping down into the river.
Whatever's making that sound, it just came out of nowhere and it just terrified me. Like, I am in the wild and there are definitely jungle sounds that I have never heard before. And look what I just found walking up this creek. Look at this. Oh, this is like doing my heart good. This is the principle of dip yourself in urban, immerse yourself in nature. My original plan was I need to get up to Quito to fly out tomorrow night. But I am so glad I stayed here instead. Look at this, I'm crossing this stream. Across this creek, and it's so wet. And like, this is just pure jungle here. Try not to fall in. This is so much better than a hostel or a hotel near the airport. But I wouldn't trade it for anything right here. This is living.
I've used my head to plan trips across 40 other countries, but my heart led me to some pretty amazing places over the last month here in Ecuador. And this is quite the finale. What I'm about to experience is not just for me. Although I'm completely alone out here, I felt I was to capture these moments with my camera and let the sounds of the jungle soothe any weary soul who is still on this adventure with me. It's time to slow down, stress less, listen with your heart, and you may just feel what it's like to be embraced by a jungle.
just couldn't resist that. Oh, just dipping my head. Waterfall in the jungle. So refreshing.
It gets dark really fast in the jungle. The light just disappears so quickly. And you hear all these sounds. Oh my goodness. I can't see with the light shining in my face. I've just been exploring through and just immersing myself in the sounds here. That is heart healing. This is what being immersed in nature feels like. There's so much greenery and shrubbery and flora around me. And apparently like birds and bugs and... Look at this. Like these huge, huge tree trunks with like these spines going down them. And I've had so many of these branches brush across my neck and face walking. I keep thinking they're snakes, you know, because you're in a jungle, right? Snakes like jungles. He did say something about snakes and wearing boots. I'm not wearing boots. I don't think he would have left me out here if it wasn't safe, you know, like if there were jaguars or something that were hungry. Wow. Okay, I need the light to like see where I'm going here. Where should I go? Wow. Like so many leaves. You hear that? And just a full canopy of trees above. Wow. Okay, this is cool. Look at that root system. It's like an inverted tree. Wow. Well, there's definitely things flying by. I can't tell if they're birds or bats, but they're like whipping past my head. But there's this super bright firefly that just flew right in front of me and then like was just buzzing around through all the leaves and everything. Just flying through, super, super bright orange. I just had the light off for a minute and was watching it. It was incredible. There's another firefly. Right in front of my face. Look how huge the trunk of this tree is. Oh, yeah. Let's listen to some sounds of the jungle. In fact, let me turn off the light and let you experience it as I'm experiencing it in complete dark as I lean against the base trunk of this tree and we listen to jungle sounds for a minute. The light is off. I'm deep in the Ecuadorian jungle. The sun has set. And based on a little bit of light that I can see through the trees, there's like a silver light. And I'm guessing it's actually the moonrise. But listen to these jungle sounds with me. Ah.
is a jungle that can take away all stresses, all worries, even the deepest of heart pains. I feel like this jungle is just absorbing all the negative and replenishing it with so much positive.
So that's what it feels like to be embraced by a jungle. The immersive sounds of nature's symphony surround my being. A mother's love embracing my broken heart with a healing hug. The sound of Roberto's canoe guides me down to the river, and I'm so glad he understood my broken Spanish to come back for me. With all my dreams fulfilled, even the deep ones within my heart, I was now ready to begin the long journey home.
Wholeheartedly happy this evening.
Ready to continue the adventure? It's only 5 buses and 5 flights over 5,000 miles before my next season begins, both in weather and in life. It all starts under a thatched roof and ends under an icy dome. You're invited.